Hello, welcome back to design of steel structural elements, that is 18CV61. So today we are going to deal with different types of steel sections like T section, I section, angle section, hollow rectangle section, hollow circular section, fabricated section, built up sections, etc. So in this class mainly I am going to deal with I sections, okay, angle sections, then the channel sections. Only these three types, because you are going to design any section using only these three types because of your syllabus. Okay, so please write down the notes. If you want to know about different types of sections, please go to class 3.7.3, page 19 of IS 800-2007. So I am going to deal with only three types of sections, as I said before. One is a T section, angle section, and the channel section. So please write down the notes. Please write down this figure. This is channel section. So this has got several components. So this part is called the web portion, and this component is called the flange portion, and this is the width of the flange, and this is the overall depth of the section, capital D. This is the thickness of the web, TW, and this is the thickness of the flange represented by T suffix F. So if you observe here, any I section flanges will not be of the same thickness or uniform thickness. So there is going to be variation in thickness. Whatever thickness we consider is the average thickness for all our calculation purposes. So when it comes to the thickness of the web, wherever the web portion is connected with the flange portion, say there is going to be a thickened part. That means where the thickness is more than the thickness of the web. Okay, and this is a circular part, and this is the quadrant of a circle of radius r1. So what is the value of r1? Here, go to steel table. If you go to a particular page and if you refer the section, so you are going to get this r value. Similarly, when you want to get, or when you need to get the width of the flange, so again from this steel table, what is the overall depth? D. Okay, and the height from here, where this curved part ends, to this place, this is called the height of the web of thickness TW. Okay, when we check for buckling of the flange, we are going to consider this height. Okay, so similarly, this is an angled section. If I call this as B and this as A, so A and B are called legs of the angle. If A equal to B, then it is called equal angle. And if the dimensions of A and B are different, if A is not equal to B, then it is called unequal angle section. Okay, and this is the thickness of the angle, and A is the dimension, that is leg length or leg dimension. This is another leg, so these are called as legs. So we have two types, one is equal angle and the other is unequal angle. Similarly, for the channel section, this is the width of the flange BF, this is the overall depth capital D, this is the thickness of the web TW, and this portion is R1, that is the radius of this quadrant, and this is the thickness of the flange TF. As I said, the thickness of the flange is not constant, it is variable. So whatever thickness we are going to consider is the average thickness. Okay, so if you open the steel table, this is the steel table by K.B. Ram. Open the first page. Please open it. You see, on the left column, it says ISJB, ISLB, etc. On the top, it says rolled steel beams. Okay, we call it as rolled steel beams because that is the process in which the section is manufactured. Okay, so it says dimensions and properties. If you look at the leftmost column, it says ISJB 150, that is one of the sections, ISJB 175, another section, etc. See, here, whenever they say ISJB, it stands for Indian Standard Junior Beam. Junior Beam. So if I say ISMB, same Indian Standard Medium Beam. Indian Standard, M stands for medium and B. Then ISWB, that is Indian Standard Wide Beam, and ISHB, Indian standard, heavy beam. Okay. So if I take one of the sections, say there is one more, that is ISLB. ISLB, that is Indian standard light beam. Light beam. So if you go to that page in the steel table, see, you see, as I said, ISJB, ISLB, ISMB, etc. If you go to the leftmost column, I am going to take one of the sections. It says ISMB 300, for example. So ISMB 300, 300 stands for the overall depth of the section. Okay, that is the way it is represented. ISMB 300. If you go to the next column where it says weight per meter N, that means weight of the section per meter length in Newton. For ISMB 300, it is 436.6. That is nothing but 436.6 Newton meter. If you refer other steel tables like Abhor, Ramamrutam, instead of giving in terms of Newton, they have given the weight in terms of kg. So if you need to convert this Newton into kg, divide the value, whatever value given in the steel table, by 9.81. Okay. Next, going further for ISMB 300, if you go to the next column, it says sectional area A, small a, in millimeter square. It says 5626. That is 5626 millimeter square. If you go to some other steel table like Ramamrutam or Abhor, they have given the values in terms of centimeter square, wherein you are going to get the area as 56.26 centimeter square. Okay. Next, if you go to the next column, that is the depth of the section, H, small h. So that is nothing but this one. This can be represented by capital D or small h. That gives the overall depth of the section. Similarly, if you go to width of flange B, that is 140 millimeter, that is 14 centimeter. So that is small b. This is another way of representing. That is the breadth of the flange. Okay. Next, that is 140 millimeter for ISMB 300. So going further to the next column, thickness of the flange TF, that is 12.4 millimeter. Okay. Next comes TW, that is the thickness of the web, that is 7.5 millimeter. If you observe, in all the sections, thickness of the web is always less than the thickness of the flange. Always. So again, why the thickness is less? That is based on the design. Okay. Next, going further, it gives IXX, that is the moment of inertia of the section, about XX axis, that is the horizontal axis. Okay, that is given as 8603.6 only. Okay, if you go up in the column to the top, so whatever value you read is multiplied by 10 to the power of 4. That means the moment of inertia of this section is 8603.6 multiplied by 10 to the power of 4 millimeter to the power of 4. Okay. So if you want to get the value in terms of centimeter to the power of 4, so whatever value you get in the table, you take as it is. That is 8603.6 centimeter to the power of 4. So if you need in terms of millimeter, multiply that value by 10 to the power of 4. So that's what it is. Similarly, you are given IYY value, which is 453.9 centimeter to the power of 4, or 453.9 multiplied by 10 to the power of 4 millimeter to the power of 4. And next column has two values, that is radii of gyration, RXX and RYY. So radius of gyration with respect to the major axis, and the next one RYY is the radius of gyration with respect to the minor axis. Again, if you go to the next column, which lies in the next page, you see zxx value and zyy value. Those are modulus of section or section modulus. So zxx value is about the major axis, zyy value is about the minor axis, that is expressed in terms of centimeter cube or millimeter cube. Okay, and whatever value you read from this, from the column, that should be multiplied by 10 to the power of 3 to know the value of zxx and zyy in millimeter cube. Okay, similarly, radius at root r1 value, this is what I was talking about, r1, that is given as 14 millimeter. Similarly, r2 value is the radius here, that is given as 7 millimeter. Okay, and it goes further and giving some connection details. Okay, and it says maximum size of flange rivet you can use. So of course we are not using rivets anymore, we are using only the bolts, so you don't have to worry about this part. And also designation, so ISMB 300 as a set is India's standard medium beam. 300 stands for 300 millimeter total height, so that's what the designation is. If you are ordering some beams, so from outside market, so you simply mention what kind of section you need: ISMB 300, ISJB 175, ISMB 600, etc. So depending on the availability of that material or the section, you will get. So coming back to this, that is the angle. If you open page number 20 of the steel table, it says rolled steel equal angles. So dimensions and properties. So equal angle means the leg sizes are the same, that is A equal to B. Okay, it says ISA 35 by 35, ISA 30 by 30. So that means ISA 30 by 30, this is the way the section is represented. So Indian standard angle, and 30 stands for the size of one leg, and the next 30 stands for the size of the other leg. Okay, ISA stands for Indian standard angle. Similarly, not only do we have 30 by 30, we have ISA 35 by 35, ISA 20 by 20, ISA 60 by 60, ISA 55 by 55, ISA 70 70, ISA 100 100, up to ISA 200 200. And of course, with different thicknesses. Okay, if I take say ISA 130 by 130, so we are going to get that angle with four different thicknesses of the angle, that is ISA 130 by 130 with 8 mm thick, again same section, same leg dimensions, with 10 mm thick, 12 mm thick and 15 mm thick. Okay, so you are going to get the details from the steam table. Okay, next, coming to page number 18, where you are going to get the details of channel sections. If you see page number 18, you have ISJC 100, for example, ISJC 125, ISJC 150, similarly ISLC 350, ISMC 100. So ISJC stands for Indian Standard Junior Channel. So ISJC, please write down, ISJC stands for Indian Standard Junior Channel. Okay, so ISLC stands for Indian Standard Light Channel. Light Channel. Similarly, we have ISMC. ISMC MC, that is Indian Standard Medium Channel. And here we don't have Indian Standard Heavy Channel, Wide Channel, no. Only three types: Junior Channel, Light Channel and Medium Channel sections. So in your syllabus, in your design, we are going to deal with mainly I sections and angle sections. So if you go further, if you go to page number 24 of the steel table, you are going to see unequal angle details. Say ISA 30-20, that is Indian Standard Angle. 30 is one leg, that is 30 millimeter. 20 millimeter is the dimension of the other leg. Similarly, we have ISA 70-45, ISA 75-50, etc. Okay, and we can go up to ISA 200-150, that is Indian Standard Angle, with one of the legs equal to 200 millimeter and the other leg with 150 millimeter and with different thicknesses. Four varieties under ISA 200-150. Four varieties means thickness of the angles is 10 millimeter, 12 millimeter, 15 millimeter and 18 millimeter available. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. With this, just I am going to go to the design of bolted connections. Please write down